Let's say we have a thought that all of a sudden is sending a signal to this body that says, "Ah, I'm in pain." It's just a thought. But we, as mankind, or the shadow, have identified with the pain since day fucking one, when the very first man, whose name is popularly known as Adam, was created and walked the fucking earth and stubbed his first toe for the first time and fucking had a thought that said, "Oh, it's painful to stub the fucking toe." So it's been, what, 6,000 years of fucking pain marinating in the human race that has caused the human race to identify with pain, or bring it back to its root, thought. That's some good shit, brothers. Yeah. Pain is just thought. Now I know why my dad always says, "It only hurts when you think about it." Makes me wonder how much my dad knows. If he knows anything at all. Yeah. Now think about this. We have a left side of the brain, we have a right side of the brain. That's just a representation of the devil and the angel. You see it in the cartoons all the time. A little devil pops up, a little angel pops up on the other side. Now I know why that picture has been around for so long in humanity. It's because the yogis have been around for a while. And they figured this shit out. They figured the fucking brain out. They figured shit out, period. These motherfucking yogis from fucking India. You know, I used to hear these motherfuckers say, you know, ever since I started getting on YouTube, I started, you know, being a figure shit. Information was being thrown at me to learn. So I'd hear this people say shit like this. They'd be like, the fuck would they say? Oh, they would group Jesus and Muhammad or some other prophet, the Buddha. They group them all together as though they're the same. And in my mind, I was like, what the fuck? Hell fucking no, they ain't the fucking same. They're fucking false fucking prophets. Now I come to realize that they all represent the same fucking thing. And that's the spiritual life. It's a life outside of thought. It's a life of realizing that we are fucking God. We are the fucking one spirit. But this body and this mind does not represent it. The one spirit sits way back, so subtle in the background, and just observes everything. Doesn't say a fucking word. Doesn't say a fucking thing. because it's so fucking confident in itself, it needs not say a fucking thing. Because it created every fucking thing. It is every fucking thing. And it owes no fucking thing no fucking excuse for its existence. And that's who the fuck we really are. We owe no fucking thing, no fucking words, no emotions, no fucking nothing. And in our true character, we are just a fucking self-confident, quiet fucking self. All fucking powerful. All fucking powerful, motherfuckers. Think on that, how fucking powerful you really fucking are. And you know what? You ain't no different from fucking me. And we ain't no different from the fucking animals or any other fucking life source around here. It all contains the one fucking spirit. We're all the fucking same, motherfuckers. Now get this. The one fucking spirit is not either male nor female. It just fucking is what it is. Yeah. Fucking soak in that yogi breath for a fucking bit. Marinade and stew with that, motherfuckers. Make some stinky ass stew with that. Or some pleasant ass shit if you have some. If you need to, drink a bottle of something that smells good. What do they call that? Goji berries? Yogi berries? Go watch you some Yogi Berry cartoons or something. Check out Mr. Fucking Ranger with a fucking boner nose. In the early 1950s when it first came out. Oh, they was some sexually active motherfucker cartoon motherfuckers back then. You start watching them early fucking cartoons, it's all full of fucking sexual cartoon innuendos. But that's another subject. Or it's another facet of the shadow. Let's get that one on the record while I can pound the fuck home my point. I got a point, motherfuckers.